I'm coming to you for the very first time from our beautiful new office facilities in Phoenix, Arizona. Because of God's incredible blessings on this ministry and the expanded opportunities of reaching so many souls for Christ, we've had to hire more staff and expand our facilities to meet the desperate need that is out there. So thanks to all of you who have supported us, and we desperately need even more support so that people can come and learn how to get free, live free, and stay free. And I'm right here in the conference counseling room where those miracles take place. So come see us and let your visit here be your miracle. I want to talk to you about prayer postures. When we talk about prayer postures, you probably think of kneeling, and that's the one people most associate with prayer, unless it's in reference to an NFL football player. The Bible is full of different descriptions of how people pray. For example, Abraham fell on his face before God. Moses reached out with outstretched hands. Solomon knelt. Jesus looked up to heaven. The psalmist talks about bowing before God. There are many ways to approach God in prayer postures. Most often we think the severest of these is prostration, where an individual lies flat on the ground on his face. But whatever the prayer posture, whether it's for petition, for humility, or to express exuberance, it's really important how it's defined and what its significance is. Things are a bit different in Eastern religions like Hinduism and Buddhism. For example, in yoga, the postures, the asanas, are designed to awaken various kinds of spiritual energy. Like the lotus position, that's the one we think of most often. We see the person sitting there with their legs crossed, but that can get even more sophisticated, like putting the tongue to the roof of the mouth, withdrawing the chin, or making sure that the spine is absolutely stiff and correct so that the energy of the demonic forces in the first chakra can be released, the so-called kundalini power. In fact, sometimes people in yoga, even so-called Christian yoga, have these spontaneous experiences when they begin to move about and sway as if they were a snake. There are also finger mudras as they're called in Buddhism. And the belief is that by pressing the fingertips together in certain ways, you release energy. They even have modalities in Buddhism of casting out demons with finger prayer postures. For example, the Karana mudra is the way that you cast out demons. You put the thumb with the middle fingers and you go like this. Now that would be news to Satanists. Satanists have taken this symbol as their own, as a way to evoke the devil. Even though in Buddhism, this is supposed to be the way of expelling demons and bringing healing. And if you want to get rid of your snake spirits in Hinduism, the nagas, well, this is the posture that you use. Many of you have seen pictures of the Buddha looking like this, and you wonder why. That is a prayer posture to get rid of snake spirits. For you proponents of Christian yoga out there who say that all of this is just meaningless, I have news for you. The prayer postures, the asanas, the positions, and even the hand mudras are all intentional. Some of them are connected with astrological signs, others planets, some sex, the one we most often think is just a symbol of respect. No. It's the connecting of the yin and the yang, the male and the female coming together as one so that the prana energy can be released specifically through the muladhara first chakra, where the Hindu goddess Shakti dwells in the form of the kundalini sexual serpent power. As you can see, there is a big difference in prayer postures. Whether it's how one sits or twists their body into some contorted position, or uses hand gestures. The difference between the Eastern modality of prayer postures and the Christian modality is really pretty simple. We worship a transcendent God, a God who is there. We are here. He is there. In Eastern mysticism, the purpose is to find the God within and to awaken the energy inside your own soul. Basically, you bypass the Creator and you, the created one, your God becomes your ego. Beware. Whatever discipline you get involved in, prayer postures are important because they may point you to the living, eternal God, Jesus Christ, or they may point you to demons and the devil.